So you are probably wondering why I'm installing a Victron SmartShunt on my battery when I've already got the DIYBMS current monitor installed. I designed the current monitor back in August 2020, and it's not significantly changed since that original design. Although I spent a long time reading the data sheets and writing code for the device, I've always had a nagging doubt that the output isn't as accurate as it should be. I've compared the outputs of the current monitor to various multimeters, the output of my so far inverter, and also other measuring devices, but I've never really had a way to validate the readings I was finding. So I thought, why not take a well-respected device like the Victron SmartShunt and run it head-to-head with the DIYBMS to compare the results. If you already use DIYBMS, you will know that you can export its data into other systems using MQTT. So that's what I'm using to push data into Open Energy Monitor. Alongside this, I've rigged up a Raspberry Pi to listen to data from the SmartShunt using a serial cable. This is also pushed using MQTT. To make sure that I'm comparing like for like, I've configured the SmartShunt to match the values in DIYBMS. I've also disabled the PuCurt exponent. This isn't supported in DIYBMS, but is largely irrelevant when using lithium battery cells anyway. And here's what I found. This graph is for the voltage. At first glance, it doesn't look great. However, there are two things going on here. The first is a drift in time. We're not capturing the two shunt readings at exactly the same moment. And so when we're populating these graphs, that's why it looks slightly off in the left to right direction. The other point to check is the scale on the y-axis. The graduations on this scale are very small, which makes the readings look drastically different. If we zoom out a little, you can see that the voltages align much clearer. Although there does appear to be some difference in the highest and lowest voltage readings. Looking at the current readings, we see a very similar pattern. Both look to be aligned well. Remember that the Victron is using a 500 amp shunt and the DIYBMS is 150 amp, so theoretically the DIYBMS should be more accurate at the lower currents. Now, what's actually more important than either the voltage or the current readings in this scenario is the amp hour counting. This is the only true way to measure the capacity and state of charge of a lithium battery. Victron and DIYBMS have different ways of reporting this data within their internal systems, but here you can see the battery discharge during the day. The amp hour count is very similar, returning almost exactly the same results. Then we come on to the state of charge percentage. This is calculated from the amp hour data as well. And as you can see, DIYBMS and Victron largely agree on the same value. Victron appears to calculate a slightly higher value nearer the top of the graph by about just under 1%. But that settles down as the battery starts to discharge. Now, the whole purpose of this test was to give myself confidence in the circuit and code I've designed and written. I'm happy that the current monitor is providing near identical values to a well-respected Victron kit. And that's great news, as I've got some changes planned for the DIYBMS current monitor to make it even easier to build and use. But you have to wait for another video on that. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel to get notified of when that video and others are released. Thanks for watching.